Welcome to our tutorial, Bionics for Education. Bionics, as you might know, is about learning from nature and solve technical problems by solutions we found in nature. Today we want to talk about the problem of grasping. We humans have the perfect tool to grip and grasp. This is our hand. We can grip nearly everything, we can manipulate the things, so it's very versatile. But in industry, however, we find usually very simple grippers. They can grip exactly the piece they are designed for, but nothing more. And therefore, engineers for a long time looked for solutions to copy the human hand, but these grippers are very complex, expensive, and therefore not well used in industry. But now some Swedish students looked for simpler solutions. They looked how a chameleon catches flies, and they found a very interesting solution to that. So how is the chameleon doing that it can catch with its tongue many different flies? So here you see a simplified chameleon head, and in this head you see in light blue the tongue, which is folded inside the mouth of the chameleon. And once the chameleon sees a fly, it throws the tongue out very fast, like a spring. And once the tongue approaches the fly, the tip of the tongue forms a cavity, and this cavity, because the tongue is soft, shapes around the fly and catches it. Here you see the technical drawing of the principle. So we have a membrane, this is light blue, and this membrane can be pulled back and forms also a cavity. And then we bring some air pressure inside the membrane, and then the air pressure folds the membrane around the gripped object, and therefore we can also grip objects with different shapes. So the Swedish students tried to copy the working principle of the chameleon tongue and design with this idea a flexible and very versatile gripper. So, and now it's time to build our own chameleon gripper, and for this we use the Bionics kit, and now we will have a closer look inside. The first thing you see is a cover with some plastic sheets we don't need for the chameleon, and then you see all the different parts you need for the three different bio-inspired robots. So for the chameleon, of course, the first and most important thing is the soft tip, see here. Then we have the body with the microcontroller inside, the middle ring with the O-ring sealings, the top cover, which carries then the soft tip. We have the servo to drive the whole thing. We need the cable ties, and we need a silicon tube. And finally, a little black tube and a balloon. So let's start the assembly. First, we need the rubber tip, and maybe you can see inside a little metal part. This is the part where we connect our cable tie. And for this, we have to turn this inside out. It's a little bit tricky. So here it is. Here you see the hole in the metal part. I put the cable tie in it and fasten it. So, and then I can push it back. Okay, now I connect the soft tip with the top part of the chameleon body, and you see here is a little groove which fixes the soft tip. So very simple. So I put this aside for a moment and take the middle ring, and now I assemble the servo motor. So there is a slot inside where I can put the servo motor in. And again, by means of a cable tie, I can fasten the servo here with the middle part. And if you make a mistake with the cable ties, don't worry, you can open them again. They are reopenable. So do this very tight. So that should be enough. And now you see the cable tie is a little bit too long. For this you take scissors or a knife like this, cut it away, and then it looks nice. And now we combine both parts here. Put together the middle part with the top part. And for this we have here this T-lock where you have to bring it in. This is a little bit tight because it needs to be airtight in the end. So a little pressure necessary. So, and then you turn it and then it's fixed. And now we have to connect the cable tie with the bar of the servo. Put this through. And now, of course, this is the front position of the tip. You move the servo back also in the front position. And now how can we secure this? Again, by help of another cable tie. We use only the lock part here, cut it away, and then put it, it's the wrong direction, this direction, put this on the cable tie, and therefore we can fix the whole thing. And now the servo can move and push back the tip of the chameleon tongue. Okay, here again, if the cable tie is too long, you can cut it away. And now we can have the first test with the microcontroller. So the microcontroller is in the body, so we have to get it out. And first you see there are bays for the batteries, so we have to assemble the batteries. You can use standard AAA batteries or accumulators as you like. Put them in. And if you switch on the controller with this little button here, then a green light gets on, and then a red light, and the red light tells you that the controller is ready. And then you have to connect the servo with one of the outlet ports here. You can take every port you want and make sure that the black cable of the servo is put on the pin with the label black, like I do it here now. So now it's time to switch on the microcontroller and see if the whole thing works before we assemble it completely. For this you have a little switch here. If you switch it on, you see green and then a red LED. And now you need a Wi-Fi device, for example my smartphone, could also be a PC or a tablet, as long as it has Wi-Fi on board. So you go to the settings and then you choose wireless LAN, and then you see a list of networks. And in fact, this controller is a Wi-Fi hotspot, and it comes with the name B4E and then a lot of letters and numbers. You choose it, and then it asks for a password, and the password is education. I hope I type it right this time. So it works. So now we are connected in a second. So we are connected now, and now you go back and open your browser and type in the internet address www.b4e.com, and then a web page opens and you see here Bionic Fish. Now we are not working with the Bionic Fish, we work with the Chameleon. So you go to this hamburger tablet and you choose Chameleon, and then you see only one slider, and with this slider you can control the position of the servo. You see, if I move this, then the servo is moving. Now that we know that the controller works, we can finalize the assembly. We put the controller back into the body. There are rails in the body who leads the controller and holds it in position. So a little push, then we put the cable in and use the same mechanism to connect both parts, carefully putting this together. Have a look on the ceilings, looks fine. Turn it. So now we are ready with the assembly, but the air pressure inside is missing. And for this we need a very simple tool, the balloon. Yeah? And to connect the balloon with the body, we use this silicon tube we can fix here. Okay, then we have the little black tube we put in here and connect the balloon with the black tube. So here we have the ready assembled chameleon gripper with the balloon as a simple pressure storage. And if I actuate the thing with my servo and the smartphone, you see there's a cavity on the tip which can catch our object, and if I release it, it comes back. Now let's have a test. So here we have a simple object, a ball, could be something else. I catch the ball, I have to be careful, and if I release it, the ball comes out again. So you could see that this bio-inspired gripper worked indeed. If you like this video and want to learn more about the Chameleon Gripper and Bionics for Education, visit us on our homepage, bionicsforeducation.com. Thank you for your attention and goodbye.